What's up? What's up? Who are we doing next? We are doing Pisces. Pisces is next. Pisces. I love Pisces. I'm just trying to get some good juju for my Pisces reading. Okay, because, you know, I do know a few Pisces. And I do love my Pisces. So, and I hate some Pisces. Not gonna lie to y'all. Let's do this shit. Today. Let's get this one done. All right, Pisces, what do we got? Why is the Ace of Pentacles here twice? This reading is crazy. The High Priestess here twice in reverse. All right, Pisces, so there's a lot going on here, a lot. I did one deck. The first deck, I used my the fountain deck. What's at the bottom here, what's not seen, is that you have your eye on the Empress. The Empress is a mother figure. She's attractive, she's beautiful. She is a go-getter. She is smart. She is wise. She's humble. She is nurturing, giving, divinely guided. And she's all of the queens in one. So you've got an issue here that you have with an Empress. Okay. Then let's see what we have. The first thing we show was the Queen of Cups. This is what's on your mind. A female figure in your life that you feel a lot of emotion for, that you feel emotional about. Oh, check it, y'all. Meal prep. I'm so amazing. Just don't mind me for a second here. Oh, and I got my baby breakfast. She's just a late starter, so we're gonna heat this up and heat that up. All right, so basically what we've got here is you're worried about the Queen of Cups. I asked who the Queen of Cups is. The Queen of Cups, my friend, if I can get these damn cards off the counter. The Queen of Cups is the person that you have decided to stop moving forward on. It is your wife. Interesting, Pisces. Or a wife-like figure. Or if you're a female, your husband. Or your stable relationship, basically. Okay? A person that you feel that you're solid with. Ah! Okay. Here. Let's get your vision there instead. My bad, y'all. Mommy duty's called, so. All right, so anyway, so what was crossing this is the Five of Wands, which is an element of competition, lots of drama, lots of gossip, that sort of thing. And I feel like the reason that this situation is not happening here is because the female or the person that you're dealing with was very upset, has guarded her heart. She has her sword here ready to fight. She is watching, she is observing, she is guided. She has messengers. People are coming and telling her things. Okay, she's outside. She probably crossed her legs and meditated before she decided to concern herself with this battle. All right? The recent past, judgment. A judgment call was made because there was an other woman that was found out. The Queen of Wands in reverse is gonna be the other woman. Okay, so something came out about another woman and a judgment call was made, most likely by the Queen of Swords regarding this situation. The current situation is there is no offer to move forward in this situation by either one of you, I would say. And I say that because it came out twice on both decks. Neither one of you wants to move forward in this situation because it is absolutely toxic. And I can say that because in a situation where we're dealing with a queen, there should be another king out here. But instead, we have the Knight of Cups. There's affection, there's love, but it's only the fun part. This is not a person putting in work, okay? When I went to clarify what this was all about, Mr. Knight of Cups, I don't know if you can tell what this looks like, likes that bow-wow a whole lot. With who else but the other woman, Queen of Wands. Bow-wow. Okay, so even though your heart may be one place, your penis is in another. Isn't that lovely? Lucky Queen of Wands she is. She's picked up a toxic mouth. Good luck, baby. I'm gonna pray for you, okay? Yeah. These people are not paying attention to their intuition, red flags on either one. They're both looking at each other like this is a match made in heaven, and it is not. You're gonna need a lot of strength to get through this situation because there's some things to take care of here. Oops. Okay, the Queen of Wands, the stick here, the toxicness, the going against intuition. This is falling to your weaknesses. This is not using your strength, sir or ma'am. This is being weak, okay? You're a little on the weak side. In the future, you're gonna get some guidance though, boo. Don't you worry. Spirit has not forgotten about you. Currently, you're not trying to listen to Spirit at all. Your intuition is shut down completely because this is crazy. This is so crazy. Just wait until I show you this. I want to clarify what this is about. I did the cards. Plop. Four things fell out. And two of them is this, boo. Two of Wands, upright. Two of Pentacles, reverse. To me, it's like you don't want to have to decide. And the reason I say that is because the Two of Pentacles reverse is next to the Ten of Pentacles reverse. The Ten of Pentacles is a solid family. It's the husband, the wife, lots of work, lots of effort on both parts. It is equal give and take, solid foundation. This is the most solid foundation you could possibly have. And this one is in reverse. You've decided to leave your solid foundation alone. You've decided to take on an opportunity, but you're really not even sure if you want that opportunity fully. So it's like this. Let me pull all these up so I can flip them just like they were. Okay, so there's you not paying attention to your intuition. The High Priestess is all-knowing, divinely guided. This is lost. You're lost. And that was 11:11 when I said that. And the beep beep is the confirmation. Your situation here is this. You've decided to let go, or you're considering, or you're thinking that you should let go of the family situation to go for a new endeavor that you're not even 100% sure about. You're really not. You can say what you want to say. So the external factors here is that your long-term commitment broke up with you and it rocked your world and switched you in a new direction. But in this situation, you've decided that it's time to stop being upset about it, because you know that you were not giving equal love, or they were not giving equal love. Okay, this is about love. This is not finances. Okay, and then this is the Knight of Cups in reverse. You were slow and steady, and you're at a standstill with this person moving forward. You don't want to be offering love that is rejected to anyone anymore, and you've made a lot of communication towards that, and it didn't work. That you are deciding that, you know, this betrayal, this Three of Swords energy that you brought to the table, or that your person also brought back to you, it caused a major tower in your lives. And this tower, even though it looks like on your end that it may have fallen, it has not. There's still ties being held here. Let it go. Karma is here just to adjust the scales. The bottom of the deck on the other one is the Knight of Wands in reverse. This is immature energy. This is a time to reflect on what you really want and stop being influenced by others. It's a time for you to actually, take accountability to what Spirit's trying to say here. And it's not necessarily that they're saying go with this person, but whatever it is, the High Priestess was in reverse twice, okay? There is definitely, a lot of stagnant energy here. And the reason for that is that you have some doors to close still, whether you want to admit it or not. And it's time to do that. So good luck with that, Pisces. Sometimes you can give a lot to a relationship, whether it's emotionally or financially, whatever. And you expect it to yield a certain result, and it doesn't. And once you guys have let each other down enough, I think enough is enough. So, the winds of change are blowing, and I suggest you make the most of it this time and get out of that childish energy, so that you don't mess it up again for yourself. Pisces, wish you the best.